Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an analog output card, an Rx3i analog output card. This is an IC694ALG392. It is an 8-channel output. It's capable of putting out voltage from 0 to 10 volts or milliamps from 0 to 20 milliamps or 4 to 20 milliamps depending on what you choose, 12-bit. So what I have in front of you here, I have the module attached to an IC695CHS007 7-slot rack. I'm using an IC695PSA040 power supply and an IC695CPU320 as the processor. Now, a couple other things that I have going on here. In order to connect up, I'm going to be using COM port number 2, and I'll be using an HE693CBL232 9-pin serial port cable from the computer. And then in order to convert it over my COM to 15-pin, I'm using an HE693SNP232 adapter. And the other peripheral items that we're going to be needing will be a multimeter. So I'll show you guys that right here. I'm using a Fluke multimeter. And this is not an option. You will need a 24-volt DC power supply. And you can see that on my terminal 1, I have my positive lead from the power supply connected, and on number 19 I have my negative lead from the 24 volt power supply connected. Okay, and then we will be showing you guys the wiring diagram. I have this for myself, but just in order to be able to touch these terminals while it's activated, I wanted to keep this open. So I have a power supply. Okay, let everything go through its self-diagnostic. One thing that you guys want to make sure is that your switch is in the far right position for the run enabled on your processor, so that when we go into run mode, the processor enables the output so that we can use the card. The other thing is I'm going to power up my power supply, and we should have an LED that turns on next to where it says power supply, and we have that now. So a couple quick things. If you guys are using this as a troubleshooting video, if you don't have a module okay blinking green light, or you go to power up your user power supply, or both of these LEDs are not on or not working, very likely that the analog card is damaged, will need replacement or repair. Okay, I'll talk about that later. So in order to test this card, we're going to need, I'm going to be using Proficy Machine Edition software. I've opened up a CPU320 blank file, and if you guys follow my arrow here, I'm going to open up my rack 0, and as you can see, I have the IC695CHS007 rack, IC695PSA040 using slots 0 and 1, so it uses two slots, and the CPU320, which is using slots 2 and 3. That leaves me with the next available slot, which I have this module in slot 4. All right, so I'm going to right click on there and select add module, or you could always double click. And it's an analog output card, IC694ALG392, 8 circuit output analog. The first thing I want you guys to notice is that when the tab comes up for slot number 4, 0.4, IC694ALG392, it has some settings that you guys are able to look at or alter or edit. The first thing I want to do is the active channels. And currently there's only one channel active. I want to change that by highlighting it and pressing 8. I want to test all 8 channels. Another thing that you guys want to notice is that your channel value reference address, where you're going to be putting the values in order to test the circuits, is analog output or AQ 00001. Alright, when we open up the table, I'll show you guys where to find that address. The next thing is output channel data. This is another editable value. Right now we're going to test 0 to 10 volts first, and then we're going to shut down and reset it for 4 to 20 milliamps. A quick note here, the terminals on the right hand side, okay, on this terminal strip, and that would be the even numbers, 2 through 16, are all voltage. Okay, on the left hand side, which is the odd numbers, 3 through 17 is current in milliamps. Okay, that's important for, you know, when you guys are able, when you're looking for the reading that you're giving. But it's also important to know that in the software, you have to make a change in the software in order to use the milliamps on the other side. Okay, so we'll get into that in just a second. Now I'm going to click the lightning bolt icon to connect up to the processor. I'm happy with all my settings and adjustments. Once I'm connected, I'll toggle to online mode. And in the bottom left hand, bottom right hand side, pardon me, should be programmer stop disabled, configuration not equal, logic not equal. All right, and that's because the processor was doing something different than what we're asking it to do now. So for that reason, we're going to go to target, online commands, clear. What I want to clear is the controller fault and IO tables, IO fault table. You don't need to clear all memory or any other you know, force values or anything like that, just these two. And that's going to keep us from getting hung up when we go to download this simple procedure that we're doing here and get it into run mode. Click on download and run, which is the icon that my arrow's over right now. The first thing it's going to ask us is, what exactly do we want to download to the processor? In this case, just hardware configuration and motion and logic. No need to do initial force values or write it to permanent flash memory. Not for this test. Okay. And at this point, you guys want to get your multimeter ready. I'm sure you guys have all used these before. I'm going to set mine to read voltage DC. If you have a multimeter like mine, that would be right here. Okay. And of course, my wiring is set up for voltage as well. You want to make sure that your test equipment is doing exactly what it is it's supposed to do when you're doing this test. So if I had my meter reading in milliamps when I go to test the voltage, of course I'm not going to get a reading that makes any sense. So make sure all your test equipment reads properly. Another thing is make sure that you understand your wiring instructions. When I test my voltage, and we're going to select OK here to get into run mode. All right, run enabled, and we have our outputs enabled, so we're in good working condition. Make sure, as I was saying before, that when you are connecting up to make to get these points, that you understand the wiring instructions. For voltage, 18 is my common. So I keep my negative terminal from the multimeter on 18 while I test each channel. Okay. Next thing we're going to do is open up the default tables. Second selection is down is analog output. Double click or right click and open. Now all the values we're able to put in here, and I'm going to give it full value. Of 32,000. 32,000 should yield 10 volts on a good working card. Okay, and we want to go all the way to channel 8. And then I'll show you guys one other quick trick, but we'll do this for right now. Okay, now if you guys are able to see my multimeter, the first thing I'm going to do obviously is connect to my 18 and touch my positive probe to the first channel, first output channel, terminal 2. Alright, now as you guys can see, I have 10 volts, second channel, 10 volts, third channel, 10 volts, fourth, fifth, seventh, and eighth. Okay, so I'm satisfied that all 8 channels are working properly. What I like to do though is, if I feel it's a card that is troubled, if you guys are noticing in the Prophecy Machine Edition, I'll cut this 32,000 to 16,000. Cut it in half. Now, if I give it half the value, I obviously should get half of the voltage. I'm looking for 5 volts on channel one right now. Hook up to my 18 and my channel one, which is terminal number two, and I have 5.002 volts. Cut it in half again, 8,000. I should get half the voltage we just saw, which is 2.5 volts. And I have perfectly and stably 2.5 volts. There's a lot of things that you may want to look for in a card like this. You want to make sure that the value is stable, that the value is not fluctuating up and down. That could be a problem, you know. So I'm satisfied with all the values there, and I'm satisfied that the voltage works. I'm going to stop the processor, disable outputs. I'm going to go into my slot 4. This is in Proficy Machine Edition. And I'm going to go to each channel and select a milliamp reading. Whatever you guys want, 0 to 20, 4 to 20, it doesn't matter, as long as it's reading current in milliamps so that we can test that side of the card, and that function of the card is what's important. All right, and this, now again, if you look below, our configuration is not equal. Our logic is equal, but our configuration isn't. It's because we're doing something a little different here. We go back to clear, like we did before, controller fault table, IO fault table, select OK, and that's because we're asking it to do something slightly different than we did before, and it knows the difference. Okay, so once that's cleared, we'll download. When it asks us what we want to download to it, we want to only do hardware configuration, motion, and logic, nothing else. We're not writing anything to the permanent flash memory. Again, this is just a test on the card to make sure it's working. So hardware configuration, logic, okay. Now another thing, while this is downloading, I might suggest that you guys leave these, maybe some of the outputs on. Leave them on for over a weekend, a couple days. Go back and test them. Make sure that they're still stable. Odds are that they could change. You know, it's possible that you may have a problem that doesn't exist until it's been running for a while. Maybe it heats up a bit and then it starts to have a problem. So keep a close eye on it for a couple days and make sure it's a good working card. And I think we're just about done downloading here. And when we are done downloading, I'm going to switch my multimeter over to read milliamps in DC, direct current. And I set up my wiring for that ability. All right, I'm going to hit OK. I'm going to go back to our analog output table. Now, we still have values in here, which is fine. So we could test all the channels. Now what I'm looking for is first on the wiring diagram, we want to connect to point number 19 where our negative terminal from the, or our negative lead from the power supply is actually coming in from. And then we'll test from channels 3 through 17, or terminals 3 through 17. So I'm on my negative terminal, I'm on channel 1, which is terminal 3. And I should have approximately or just over 20 milliamps. Okay, and I do. I have 21 milliamps. Channel 2, channel 3, channel 4, channel 5, channel 6, channel 7, and channel 8. Another thing that we see in the field, of course, is the reason that I drop these values down is because an analog card will commonly fail at full value. So what that means is I may put a value of 8,000 in there and still get 21 milliamps, and I may put a value of 16,000 in there and still get 21 milliamps. That's wrong. I should only get 21 milliamps on this reading, on this multimeter, if I've given it full value. So now that I've dropped the value down to 16,000, all right, I've cut that in half, should have a value of 12 or 13. Okay. And there we are, 13. Again, I could drop that in half. Look for my value. Value of 9. Okay. The other thing is to make sure that when you're checking these values, you check for the fluctuation I was describing before. You make sure that it's not going up and down on its own. It should stay stable. Okay, that's the other important thing. So anyway, this is a complete thorough test on this card. It's an ALG392 again. I'm satisfied that both voltage and milliamps, current reading and milliamps, is working. So I would say that this is a good tested unit, and if you guys are able to follow this test and you're able to get all the same results that I did, I would say that you have a good working unit. If there is a problem, it may be elsewhere. Take note for all the things that I described that could be wrong with it, simply with just not getting any lights on. ALG392 could be troubled, may need replacement or repair if you're unable to follow the test thoroughly. And we do repair these quite commonly at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.